folks. Jake and Aretha and I are all here, and we want to do a contest entry for Rob Walker's 100 subs contest. And so Rob is kind of a new channel to me. I'm still kind of watching his videos and learning what he does. It appears to me that he shows a great variety, and shows a lot of records I've seen before and a bunch that I haven't, and that's always cool. And really dig the jazz. So anyway, he's asked for 5 albums that you've never shown in a video before, and you know that gets kind of tough. I almost feel like I love you too, buddy. I almost feel like it's kind of hard to remember. And so going back there, I think I found 5 that I haven't shown. I'm not even sure if I've ever shown anything by some of these bands. And I don't know that I've ever seen anything by any of these bands on YouTube. So let's jump into this, shall we, Jay? How about it? What do you think, Aretha? Now, she's too busy looking at Jake's tail because it's twitching. Anyway. The first CD is New Jerusalem. This is a Christian hard rock band, self-titled album. Maybe a good reason that, well, as far as I know, this is the only release that they put out, and it is a bit of an uneven album, I must say. The songs I like the best are the ones where they just get right out there and rock hard. It's an uneven album, but when they are on, they do pretty good. I kind of hear a couple different influences, almost AC/DC at times, maybe a little Led Zeppelin, but could have done with a little bit more consistent album, but still, New Jerusalem. Second CD is Mike Knott, Strip Cycle. Mike Knott is the principal songwriter, frontman for the band, for the Christian rock band, Lifesavers Underground. They've gone by Lifesavers Underground, LSU, just a bunch of names, but Mike Knott, this is a solo album. It almost sounds like he did the whole thing. It's a very raw album, and almost sounds like he did the whole thing on a guitar that's probably on its last leg. I don't know if that makes any sense, but it's an extremely raw album. I would say if I've ever shown an album that I would recommend to Vinyl Richie, it would probably be it. This has a, I almost feel like he would like this. And that's Mike Knott, Strip Cycle. Some great songs on here. two of my favorites. I'm a big fan of, well, actually, there's a lot of good songs on here, but Supergirl. Song, and so is Rockstars on H.
Rockstars on heroin, who's to blame for letting them in? They were cool when they were poor, now they're just rich, spoiled druggies on horse. Rockstars on heroin. Rockstars on heroin. Jobs for Rockstar, damn. Just a waste that they can't play at all. Just what I need, some more winter role models. Rockstars on heroin. It must be tough to be rich and famous, big and blameless, pushed by your record company. Get your name in billboard, receive phone words while the illegal ding overseas.
That's Mike Knott. This is a, what year is this? 95 on Tooth and Nail. So, CD number 3. This is a band called the Urban Hillbilly Quartet. And this album is called Beautiful Lazy. And they are a hodgepodge or a mishmash even of musical sounds, but a great band. I saw them live at Cornerstone one year, and yeah, they really do mix up their sounds quite a bit. This album is a 2000 True Tunes record, so I probably saw them about the time this album came out. I think I saw them. I also saw them once at the Rudyard Kipling when it was still here in Louisville. Unfortunately, that place folded, and that's a shame. It was a unique venue, but yeah, Urban Hillbilly Quartet.
Your heart left yesterday, your soul tomorrow. Your conscience split with the Queen of Sorrows. Such a trick deck to the spade of ace. But this ain't something that games will replace. There's blood on the door and blood on your hands. You're up to your neck in the blood of the lamb. What else is there to understand? You're drowning in the blood of the lamb.
CD number 4. Terry Scott Taylor, Avocado Fault Line. This may be the best written album that I'm showing you, or CD that I'm showing you tonight. I don't think any of these were ever pressed to vinyl. This came out on Silent Planet back in 2000. Terry Scott Taylor, he's the principal songwriter and frontman for the band Daniel Amos, who's also gone by the Daniel Amos Band, Daniel Amos, Da. They went from country rock to alternative rock, but this album I would describe as Americana. I will tell you a couple of my favorite songs. Well, there's Pie Hole, which is a song about a woman with a crude mouth that he wishes would shut her pie hole. But my two favorite are Pretend I'm Elvis for Just One Night.
We all need God's redemption, honey. Tonight Graceland is a bar. And even if I can't sing too good, play the guitar. I think I could love you tender, treat you like a queen. We can work a little magic if you imagine I'm the king. And pretend I'm Elvis for just one night. I will call you Priscilla if that's alright. Don't we look sort of like him in the neon light? And you pretend I'm Elvis, darling, for just one night. Did you preach?
And Papa danced on Oliveira Street. And that one probably hits home for me because he's writing about his father and the relationship they have and how he got to see a different side. You know, there was this one time this band was playing and his papa just it was filled with such joy and you got to see that. He got to see that because he got up and danced. And it was in that moment he just saw his dad in a different light. And I had a similar experience with my mom about a year before she died. We went out to something called the Flea Off Market here in Louisville. And just a bunch of vendors. And one of the tents was this rescue group that had a bunch of puppies, and you could pet them for a donation to the rescue. And my mom saw the puppies, and here's the 76-year-old woman, and she is wow. I mean, I think in that moment, God let me see my mom as a small girl, and just the joy she had. She just couldn't wait to hold a puppy, and so that's why that song means something to me.
She couldn't help herself, 'cause the day was warm and the sight was oh so sweet. And the crowd laughed too at the joyous soul, made her day complete. With his family gathered on Father's Day, Dad's love ran wide and deep. And he sits with his little dance down on old Oliveira Street. In a world that wounds us time to time, that glimpse of grace was so sublime. Though the angels now live in Anaheim, they flew in for just a peep at that miracle of a fandango down on old Oliveira Street.
Trying not to get emotional. Anyway, the next album, The Mighty Jeremiahs. Blues rock band. Some of these guys are from the Kentucky Headhunters. I think it's Greg Martin, Jimmy Hall, Mark Hendricks, and John McGee. And I'm pretty sure Greg Martin is from the Kentucky Headhunters. I don't know if any of the other guys are. I'd have to look it up. But the Mighty Jeremiahs, this is a gospel blues project.
Well, my mama always told me, get down on your knees.
great, great songs. Love that that it was done on EarXC Records. EarXC was a record store here in town that unfortunately folded. Man, what a great place to buy records and CDs. I used to like to go I loved to stick my nose in their UCD bin anytime I could because they put demos out a lot of times. You get new CDs cheap that way. I know they're not supposed to, but and then that logo, you might actually see it someday. That logo was on bumper stickers and I think they've pretty much gone nationwide. So those are my five. So, man, I'm going to get off here because I want to put some samples in there for you. And hope everyone's having a great week. And we will see you soon.